Good evening, good evening, good evening, and welcome to what should be an exhibition of roller hockey inline. For those of you who don't know me and are a little uninitiated to this level and this particular competition, my name is Pete Wirt, former GB manager of the Inline Masters for 5 years and 5 World Cups. And it's my pleasure to attempt to try and guide a few of us through this match tonight and many matches else. And a particular pleasure, although as a GB resident of some more than 22 years, born and raised in Winnipeg, Manitoba, on the mean streets of St. Vital and the brick walls of Dakota Collegiate Institute, where I never played but certainly honed a love of hockey, like most of my compatriots and countrymen. So I have a particular, maybe thinly hidden bias tonight, seeing my teammates, countrymen, competing and representing the Canada. Nonetheless, though, many of the Italian team on this B side are close friends that I've met on the field of battle and on the field of a couple of frosty beverages on an Italian evening after a hard-fought match in the Italian sun. And I would quite honorably and be honored to say that most of them are good friends as well as great competitors. We are in the 7th Masters Inline Hockey World Cup in Bolzano, Bozen, Italy 2016. The 7th of these World Cups and this growing sport. You're never too old to teach a few of these old dogs some new tricks. And hopefully tonight we'll see the internationally renowned Masters of Hockey, who got off to a bit of a slow start in this tournament, stand up and show the rest of the world that at any level, Canada is the dominant force. Versus Italia B in this World Cup, and we kick off. Canada taking their time on the puck now. Bennett rolling the puck around, not rushing. Just seeing what the Italian team are going to do when Canada have got possession. But they've certainly got legs. Might not be able to walk that one downtown on the stretch. Centering pass. Ooh, could have taken a shot, but took the deke. Tried to backhand it up on the corner, but a little bit soft. Just probing, testing. Seeing what the Italian defense have got to offer. Try and stretch the legs a little bit. Send a few passes down. That one was a little wide. Canada look to ideally dominate possession. Italia B in the bottom of this particular pool, but definitely not making up numbers, a strong side, but struggling now that the level of this competition has risen so dramatically, and in particularly this year. Canada's hockey pedigree sending fear into most of the other teams represented, but yet in their first match struggled to get off the blocks and tied 3-3, scoring a goal just at the very last minute to eke it back against the Swiss team, who've proven to be perhaps one of the teams to watch for a gold medal position, if not certainly some kind of medal. Canada definitely settling into their own game now. Presenting good shape. Little centering pass there. Tried to take it on the back end, maybe underneath or behind his legs. Italian defense staying tight inside and just trying to clear with a long pass. Not likely to see the Italian team forecheck too strongly, although coming off the bench. Oh dear, line changes a little bit sloppy. Canada should be taking advantage of this. Should be easy, but didn't quite know what to do. A little miscommunication there. Players a little bit in a scramble, but managed to pick up the loose puck in behind. Settling down again. Now the Italians have got a high forechecker on and disrupting maybe some of that play. Canadians try a snappy backhand. Italian beekeeper risen to that occasion. This is the Masters hockey. These are over 38s on the on inline wheels. But we're playing on a full-size ice hockey rink here with a steel mat surface, similar to sports court if you're in North America. Newly laid, so it's pretty sticky surface. And just about as near as you can get to the real thing. If you haven't got the plant and machinery to build yourself a giant ice cube. Pedigree of roller sports in Europe, very strong. So they do have an awful lot of hockey, and Italians, no strangers to it, especially up in the Alps, in the Alpine regions, lots of ice and roller hockey played. Testament to the fact is that we've got this spectacular arena to play in. Canada going on the guns, putting the jets on. Oh, took his time, found the spot. High stick side, the goalie went down to try and cover. Canada quite happy to take their time and wait for just the right opportunity to pot in. And Falso, number 87, picking his spot and making it count. Canada now obviously settling into the match, into the games. Stretching. Ooh, crossing pass. Taking that pace. Italy failed to clear though. Stretching. Push that puck almost straight into the top of the goal on the stick side. Italy pushing forward a little bit now. But not stressing Canada too much on the defense. And then not facing very much pressure. Fresh legs for the Italian team as the Canadians push deep. Taking the individual player right downtown. Crossing pass and just tips up and over the net. This is a quite a unique thing that we've built here in this Masters tournament in line. Not a professional league by any stretch of the imagination, although some of these players are ex-professionals. Just a little bit past their sell-by date, but not quite willing to give up the game and their sticks. Cheeky little giveaway, wasn't paying attention, trying to defend, stretching, turning Deakin in front. All the pressure on the Italians now, the wide open holes in the defense. What little pressure there was, just enough to put off the Canadian attack. Not at full pressure yet, Canada. Definitely got some spare gears. Speaking to Mike Hunt the other day, after their early draw in their opening match, the debut match of the World Cup. Whoa, stretching the keeper there. Italian attack holding on a little bit longer than you'd expect and asking some questions. Of Nightingale, the big keeper. Didn't trouble him too much. Probably just woke him from his little nap, but he looks set, ready to go now. So in the slow build up to this particular sport, we've grown an army of volunteers, patriots, passionate supporters of the game, mothers, brothers, fathers, sisters, aunts and uncles, family, friends, favors called in. No one's paid, no one's a professional. Just a group of amateurs, and as you can probably tell, myself included. But very pleased and, oh! Pleased to watch that kind of hockey. When someone comes round the back door like that at pace, and you can hit the tape with that sort of a pass, Italy are going to be in some trouble. Number 19. Darren Gentes smartly putting that to bed and quite liking it, really. Seemed very pleased with himself. I think this is just a little taste of what could be to come from what's shaping up to be a very professional, very organized team. Mike Hunt, the captain, now circling around, taking his time on the puck, drawing some Italian defenders with him. Said yesterday that they had plenty of gears. Here's one of them. Doesn't quite come off. Maybe a little bit disappointed and surprised that they couldn't get a better result on their debut match at this level in the World Cup. Bit of a giveaway pass there, but there's not too much pressure on the Italians. Not too deep on the forecheck, and so the Canadians can forge just a little mistake. It'll be one of few. Rolling puck, just rolling into the corner under a little bit of a pressure from the dreadlocked Italian. But an appreciable little respect shown there. And you'll absolutely find that at this level, as competitive as they are, we all know exactly what level we're at and why we're here to play this game. And it's the game that's always the winner. And that's just proof of it right there. Pay attention, soccer fans. This is how we roll. And it looks like this is how the Canadians are going to roll. Patient, organized, and a little bit of pace. Got wheels coming in on the center. Doesn't want to make the pass too early. A little bit sloppy now, giving away, but also picked up. Number seven, ooh, takes a little slip. That little sticky patch appearing again. It's appeared before in these games. Canadians putting pressure on, not letting the Italians clear. Picks up the puck from in behind. 87, bit of pressure on. Still circling, still fighting to keep the puck in. Man on the point though, wide open. If he gets this centering pass, it's gonna get potted in. There it is. But the keeper just shut the gate and scoops up the puck. So, here we are, our little army of volunteers, family and friends, all for the love of the sport, myself included. So you'll forgive us for a few rough edges from time to time. And if you do, I hope you'll let me share a little bit of my passion for the sport as well. As the Canadians doing their job, doing it right, circling around, pressing quite deep. A lot of Canadians really deep in the zone. What amounts to a neutral zone on a rink in this shape. Just on either side of the red line. Canada is pressing deep inside the Italian part of it and holding station there, not in a rush. Italians reluctant to commit too many players to try and take on Canadians individually. Quick snapshot. Taking on the pads, loose, still collected by the Canadians. Little tic-tac-toe, stretching around, keeper dancing to try and prevent any holes from appearing. Nothing doing, Canadians using their strength in the back. Tried the centering pass from behind the goal, but just tipped away and cleared. Canada will circle around. A little bit of pace now. Put some jets on. Outlet. Was it a hit from behind? Referees are going to call it. More traditional ice hockey players are going to find the game a little on the gentle side. Not necessarily because the bones of these old men can't take it. The Canadians are certainly up for it in their first couple of matches, playing a little bit of the rough stuff, but nothing unfair, just, you know, pressing. But in Europe, you're going to find that they prefer a technical game much more than a physical one. Sticks. Any little touch is going to get a call, and you'll see that. But generally speaking, a fair check should be let go here. Like Mike said to me the other day, though, Canadians always receive the very best game of whoever they face, as they want to impress. Canada, though, expected to be completely organized in their setup around this power play. Not really needed. Is he going to let one loose? Oh, little cheeky one. Tried to go in the five hole on the floor. Couldn't find the tip. And the clearance. Puck bouncing quite lively off of the backboards. Inline puck is a plastic composite and considerably lighter than an ice hockey puck. Big shot! Saw his mark from miles out. Keeper was down on the floor. Took the shot. Laser beam. Top corner glove of the keeper in Italy, and probably don't think he realized it was in until after it came out again. Had some zip on it, that shot. And well potted. Canada 3-0 up. It's only 10 minutes gone in the first half. Roller hockey at this level has two halves, 20 minutes each. Clock stops in the last two. So Canada setting out their stall and going forward pretty strong now. I think they can probably start to get a sense that there are plenty of vulnerabilities in this Italian side defending. And I would likely expect Canada to start ramping up through the gears now, taking some pace. And knocking a few goals in, especially if they think that they can take a slap shot from high up on the point. They'll pot those in. They'll pot cheeky goals from behind the post. They'll do individual efforts. Italian B stretching, defending as well as they possibly can against this organized side. Trying to keep their structure, getting a little bit tied up in knots. Keeper just gathered that with his glove. Was down on the floor and wasn't going to be able to slide across. Just managed to stretch the glove out and collect it. Oh, Canada wins the face-off in the Italian zone. Quick little pot shot. Clearance a little untidy, but it just gives them time. Players out of the box. And we're back on four. Straight downtown, looking for the switch. And the tap to put it in, but didn't find it. Italians pressing forward now in numbers. Tried a cheeky little wrister. Went high to the glove, but pretty easily gathered up. The Italians will definitely take their chances from time to time, like many of the teams that are at the beginning of their learning curve in terms of hockey. Although extended in age, many of the Italian B players, the second Italian B team, not here just to make up numbers, but definitely not the full strength side of their brothers in the other pool, who played France the other day in an electric match and won on their national sport day. Captain Mike Hunt showing why he gets to wear the C. The Italians not really quite used to the speed at which the puck comes off of these Canadian sticks. It's going to catch them off guard, and then they're really going to need to be at their very, very best. Little of the body language starting to show on the Italians now. I mean, they must have known coming out that this is going to be a really tough match for them. A little bit of organization, though, might just stem the tide. Canada 4, Italia, nothing to show for it yet. 7:57 left in the first half. Goes pretty quick. Cross-ice pass. Looking for a center in front of the goal, but doesn't pick it up. Italians moving forward in three, but look at the quick back check of the Canadians. Bobbling puck in front, just falling in behind the Italian attack. Center line shot, bobbling pass, just dropped enough. Little top spin forehand. The Canadian keeper had tracked it all the way and just gathered it in his bicycle basket. Canadians can't be complacent. The Italians definitely capable and hungry enough to go forward in numbers. And they will be able to pass that puck in front. So they're going to need to back check. And they did just enough there. Don't think we've yet really seen the full pelt of the Canadian wheels yet. Should be exciting when they face some stiffer opposition and start to stretch themselves. Great centering pass. Taking it on the point. Little deke. Toe drag. Went round on the backhand, but couldn't quite shut it. A nice little shoulder pat to say sorry for rolling over top of you. Heart of a lion. Number 17. But the brakes of a Fiat. And not one of them fancy new ones. Canadians, another face-off in the Italian zone. Didn't quite win it, but managed to gather it. Number 4 on the Canadian side, taking his time. Circling around the center spot. Picking his moment. Doesn't like it. Take another turn. Little cheeky backhand pass, but under some pressure from the Italian defense. Uses his shoulder to muscle it through. Comes in front, maybe tries the deke. Keeper swings it around back behind him. Gathered up by the Italian defense. Can they break out? Canadian forecheckers making it a little bit difficult. A little bit of a scrappy thing there. Bobbling puck on its edge. Canadian have got men forward. Slap shot coming in. Hard shot right off the pads. Bounces loose though. Can the Italian defenders turn and take it? Under a little bit of pressure, but he manages to break loose. And here come the Canadian defenders then, switching over. Number 77. Stretching. Italians defending in numbers and managing to get a back check. Shutting the door on that. And the Canadians all settle back down and take another chance when it comes. Fresh legs on the Canadian side. 16, Ross taking his time, doing his job. Passing around the neutral zone now, just trying to stretch the Italian defense, see if they'll follow. They will. Patience going to tell here. The Canadians have got bags of it. Little deke around the outside. Doesn't find the short side of it. Tries to crossing just in between his legs. Can't find the shot. They're well defended. Turned him though. He's going to go in for the deke. Takes his time. Waits for the keeper to commit, but just couldn't lift the puck up. Now a little bit of pressure from behind. Not quite boarding. Outlet pass. Under too much pressure. Tried to find a cross pass there and maybe get in behind the Canadian defense, but just tucked underneath the shoulder of the Canadian defender, maybe hit his handbag. Here comes the big T. Whoa, wrister, lightning shot. That's going to be a sharp shot. Here comes again, maybe he'll try again. Willing to take the deke on. Earned himself plenty of space, but generously gave the pass away. Still couldn't find the finish. All the right elements were there. Picked it up again, made the cross-ice pass. Oh, lazy defending. Canadians just peppering everything that they've got, picking up all the scraps. Nothing, no signal from the referee. What's he doing? Keeper's asking the question, green light's on. But as he gathers the puck out of the back of the net, the conclusion is foregone. And the Canadians picking their way through the popcorn and spat the seed right in the back of the net. Now the referees are having a little discussion here just on the short side. Both sets of players taking time to just relax on the bench. The Italians will be relieved of the break. So, decision made. Referee's going to go tell the Canadian captain. Still waiting for some sort of signal from the referees as to precisely what the situation is. Certainly having a discussion about it. Number two ref discussing the situation with the scorekeeper. Nothing. Ah, and there it goes, up on the board. The goal counts. Canada 5, Italia 0. 4:27 left in the first half. How long it takes to explain that the goal counts, I don't know. It seems a pretty simple concept to me. Pucky going netty. Goalie scorey. But I'm sure there's a much more complicated technical European definition that we can extract. Nevertheless, Canadians pick up the scraps and pot. It's not an overwhelming scoreline. The Italian B team are at the bottom of their pool, having struggled against all their other opposition. And Canadians coming here with high expectations. And the captain being proven right. In fact, they do have extra gears, maybe not just the one. Face-off takes us in the last 4.5 minutes of the first half. Canada 5 goals to the good. And I expect the captain to step right up and take charge and pot a few in for himself. Again, taking a shot from right in the center spot. Italians on the counter, though. In numbers, but look at the back check on the Canadians. 1, 2, 3, 4, all back. And then stretching again. So good wheels on the Canadians. Crossing outlet. Possession, plenty of time. Goes for the wraparound, but doesn't need to. Just waits patiently for the defender to get drawn. And then feeds his captain, who's patiently waiting. With a whole wardrobe full of space to shoot at. Captain Hunt settling in to be the top goal scorer for his team. As much as I'd like to have an army of volunteers up here to calculate statistics for me and be tapping away, I have to rely, just like you do, on the stats that come through as and when. But do check out the website, and hopefully you're watching now live on the stream. Worldwide, Australia, Great Britain, Canada, USA, and all over Europe for the first time. Adding finally to what's hoping to be an increasingly professional and increasingly prestigious sport. And as you can see here, Canadians on their debut World Cup at this level, showing what needs to be done to the rest of the teams. Showing what 38-year-old men can do if given the chance to keep their wheels rolling and their families appeased as they travel abroad. Although the Canadians, having brought a good handful of a contingent to support them, the arena beginning to fill up with Italian supporters. Pretty excited about the match to follow with the Italian A team playing what could be another big tough match for them versus the USA immediately following. Centering pass. Tries the shot. Does it tuck underneath? Penalty on the play. Slash called. And I think the Italian player knew he was going. Number 56. Amadi. Doesn't take much to get a slashing call here. You just have to gently rub the sticks together. Not even enough to make a spark, and they will call it. Any kind of stick play is frowned upon at this level. The referees having taken some time to train and get some consistency, knowing that this year with 12 teams showing up for this world championship, it was important to also sort of raise the profile and raise the standards of the referees. Canadians just tossing the ball around the diamond, playing around at their pleasure, relaxed, good tape to tape passing. That one didn't quite come off. Consolidating through the gap, finding the tip. Keeper stretching, closing the door so no pucks slide underneath. And so, the Canadians settle back to try and undo the next attack puzzle. Italians not too keen to pressure them too much. Maybe a little bit worried now. See what the Canadians can do. About to let rip. Decided not to. Through the gap again. And then the keeper, spending so much time on the floor, now having a good think, realizing how tough this match is going to be. Those shots are going to come in from all angles. And that was a pretty tight one. Still went in front of his face and found that corner above his glove. It's a warm evening here. At least on the ice, it's a little bit cooler out here. It's in the mid to high 20s and extremely humid, which makes it very tough. Oh. Individual effort, skating around, trying to deke everyone. Still there in front. Puck left on its own, still sitting. Up in the air, bobbling around. Italians finally take some possession of the rolling puck under high pressure from the Canadian forechecker. They're not going to let it go. Doesn't get cleared. Picking up the scraps off the boards. Turning. A little bit better possession on the puck strength. And the glove does work this time. Scoops up. Consolidates. What can they do, the Italians? They've just got to hold their station. Try and keep as much defensive structure as they possibly can. And pick their moment. If they do get one, they'll need to be on it. Canadians look like they know how to back check. Big slap shot. Didn't quite get the power that he needed on it. And we round off the first half. Canada 7 to the good. at what could be considered a canter. Boys doing a fine job, really professional, sticking to the game plan. Italy, not really quite sure what to do. Italy B have faced tough opposition before. They find themselves on the defensive an awful lot, so it's not that unfamiliar position for them, and they can and do scoop out chances. But are they getting their heads down now? Is fatigue taking its toll? Canadians seem pretty fresh. They've skittered off back to their bench. The Italians just going to sit on their bench and... Canadians back in the dressing room just to have a quiet chat. They came out quite late. The Italians were warming up for a good 10 minutes. Canadians came out just at the last minute, did a couple of horseshoes. And the Italian team just trying to come up with a plan. The coach just going along, encouraging each of their players, trying to encourage them to keep the energy going, keep their legs. Toughest job in the world, especially on roller boots, heavier than skates themselves. When you're on your toes defending, dancing, squatting, spinning, turning, it is just a grind. Having had plenty of experience as a GB defender myself for 5 World Cups and 3 Lignaro friendly tournaments, I know what it's like to be perpetually boxing up, sitting at the cage, watching the opposition dance around me and hoping it would all just be over soon. Thankfully, I get to sit up here and watch somebody else sweat for a change. Just a breakdown for you a little bit about what's happened so far in terms of the scores. Canada's opening match against the Swiss. Last ditch, last minute efforts to eke out the draw. Canada not quite coming out of the blocks. And a 3-3 scoreline versus the Swiss. Strong team. Mike Hunt said to me that they were expecting the Swiss to be strong, maybe even stronger than the Slovaks. He said to me that the Canadians' plan was to maybe just slow the game down a little bit, take it under their control. Looks exactly like they're sticking to that game plan. Scored 5 against the Slovaks, who managed to put in 2 past the Canadian keeper. Just incidentally, the Slovakian team and the Swiss team drew 6-6 this afternoon. So Canada neatly carving out a top spot in this Pool C match. Taya B struggling in the tournament compared to their big brother. Hopefully they're inspired their big win the other day against the French. They've conceded 14 goals against Slovakia. Again, Canada beat them 5-2, so can Canada score another 7 in the second half? Will they have the will to do it? The Italian team is as tough as a job as it is. They've got a lot of nerve and a lot of chin to come out against what they know are going to be extraordinary opposition. And are hopefully really up for it. And we'll make sure that the Canadians have to work for every goal that they score. Real pleasure to meet some of the Canadian chaps last night. They were especially surprised to find out that I was from Winnipeg. And I had a few chats with some of my fellow Winnipeggers there. Mike Hunt wants to say hi to all the guys at the office. You probably should be working. Don't spill your lunch when he scores his next goal. Vic, Ken, Jeff, and Jen, Winnipeg Electrotech. And let's not forget what's rumored to be the whole school. Junior Huntsy, Nick, Jen, and family in the PEG. And all the players playing in the CCRH. You are most welcome here to this first ever live streaming of the Masters. Growing from a really small, really family-oriented, unknown little tournament, touring around Europe, inviting the Australians to try and make it as much of an international tournament as we possibly could. Now, honored, pleased, and impressed with inviting the North Americans, who had a real competitive edge to the rest of this tournament, and raising its profile ever more. So hopefully the experiment's working for all of you guys back there, and you're enjoying this spectacle as Canada continue to make every effort to dominate hockey in all of its forms. Italia B raising their chins to it and hoping that they can do well by their country in their home tournament. Whoa! Anytime Mike wants, he can skate right up to the keeper and spin one in. I don't even think that was his best effort, but saw a little gap there on his glove side, wristed it through, too much power. Canada face off again, and it looks like their intention is to get another 7 goals and maybe more to try and equal the Slovaks' efforts against them. Italia B are battlers, though, so don't write them off just yet. Skate handling display. Patience. Waits for the keeper to go down. Number 22. Brian just waiting for that laser beam to find the gap. And then he puts it. Captain making sure that the referee knows who scored that. Canadians win another face-off as the puck bubbles on and just falls into the backyard. Time to practice their breakout. Great outlet pass, taken on the run. All the patience in the world, waits for the keeper to go down. That spot above the glove hand proving to be a little bit of a weakness. The Italian keeper's got to be wise to that now. The Canadians maybe just wondering if there's anything else they need to do. Strength on the puck is good. The Italians might manage to finally get some possession. Nice little centering pass, though. Can't quite control it well enough to take it on. A little off balance. Italians in possession, though. Canadians have got three back. The number 52, dreadlocked Italian player, just trying to find a little hole. Canadians on the counterattack, really strong. Takes all the time in the world in front of the goal. Centering pass right onto the tape. Quick twist, backhand and in. You'll never guess. Right above the glove side. And Canada's march continues. 11 goals. Italia B, 0. 18:25 to go. And plenty of time. Falls are at the face-off. Italians kick the puck through but don't possess it. Loose wheel roll in. Captain lays it down. Taking possession right round the corner, maybe a cheeky little backhand, just testing the keeper there. That gap's been open an awful lot before, so it was worth a little cheeky shot. Keeper ready for it this time, maybe shutting that door. Important face-off win for the Italians, and they do. It spits out, unluckily. Slap shot from out of town. Puck a little loose. And the goal is given. The Italians don't think it ought to be, though. They thought the puck was trapped, but it wasn't. Keeper was falling backwards. Puck spit out just a little bit. Number 77 from the slap shot in deep. Seven dives in. Fishes it out. Keeper shaking their head at the referee straight away. But referee says absolutely. And the Canadians congratulate themselves on another effort. Still a discussion. I don't know what he hopes to do, this Italian player. He's not going to undo the goal now. Might just get inside the mind of the referee for the next one. And Canada march on, 12-0. 17:43 left to play, second half. Canada hoping to march on to the full 14 to match the Slovakian score. And absolutely put to bed any discussion of whether or not they've come here to top this group and to take their first gold medal and a giant gold cup nonetheless. Every attempt to emulate the Stanley Cup with this year's cup newly bought as a permanent fixture for the team to share for the year that they own it. Perhaps Canada intends to sign it first. Taking the time, little stick handling, but couldn't find the gap through number 44. Skates, a little bit of pressure. Could take a slap shot, bobbling. Went past the keeper there. Oh, keeper's diving. Not realizing the rebounds come off of the backboards. Keeper had to take a flying leap. Did the full Superman. Didn't really need to. That's the first time that keeper's really been tested. Probably only just waking up from his nap now. Maybe having a little word with himself saying, stay in this game, it's not over yet. I'm certain that Canada would be best pleased to keep the shutout. Captain Hunt calmly dropping off the pass to number 22, Brian. Moving the puck around in the neutral zone. Hunt taking it back a little bit, giving himself some space. Lots of options. Stretching the Italian forechecker out of the way. Now Canadian 3-on-3. Pressing in. Does the fake slap. Takes the turn. Back in the lounge. Feet up. Flicking through the channels. Quite happy to send it back. Nothing on. Next one, nothing on there. Next channel, spits through out of nowhere. The Italian defenders maybe just getting a little bit mesmerized. And the Canadians just sneak in the back door, undo the lock, and wallop, punished. Nil. 15 minutes, 14 seconds to play. It's got to be tough out there for the Italian B team. As stiff and as broad as their chins might be, it's hard to take. Canadians playing it fair and clean, but not sitting back. Goal difference may yet just play a factor. but Canadians not really being tested here too much. Can they hold their concentration? Or will they go to sleep holding the remote with their feet up watching telly? Crossing pass to the other side. Dealt with on the boards. Little turn. Trying to pressed off the puck. And maybe a little breakaway. The puck is bobbling away. 28 takes it on. Wants to do the little deke. Just got the better of him. Gravity not his friend on that little burst. Strong on the puck, the Canadians. And once again, consolidate. Not too much depth to the Canadian forecheck. And they slowly break out. Not too much pace. And they'll hold it in the neutral zone while they exchange for a couple of fresh legs. Canadian player deep, just sprinting off the board. So all of a sudden, crossing pass isn't quite on, so he goes all the way through. 44, Quebec quite happy to bring it back into the neutral zone and play around with it. Maybe a little bit of complacency there, Canadians. Not being tested by the Italians, so there's no rush. But they might just be tempted to drop that puck in behind. A little bit of pressure on. Italians could have dealt with that a little bit better in the defense. Try not to get dizzy. Squeeze that little puck out. Mishandled. 64's got a breakaway. Great back check, though, from the Canadian defender. Pressed him hard. No sign of any twitching of the hands from the referee. Italian still got possession, but unlucky. Just not that confident on the puck. And the Canadians breaking forward in threes, twisting the defense all over the shop. The wrister just going over top, luckily enough. Italians breathe a sigh of relief as they try and rub their eyes and reestablish the balance. 12:28 remaining in the half and the game. Canada 13 goals to the good. Another one to get to equal the Slovakian score. Here it probably comes. Takes his time. Ooh, tries a little bit of a lazy shot just down on the bottom. Now this line might pick up the pace a little bit. Number 22, Brian, stick handling in front, finding the space, stretching. Does he make the centering pass? He doesn't. Sends it back. Let's Brian circle around. Probably going to drop this into the neutral zone through his legs. Who wants it? Splits. Defense still following. Paces too much. Decides it's not on. Turns back. Centering pass. And back again. Patience. 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 Waiting for the right opportunity. Captain skates backwards along the boards and takes the puck back in his stride and decides he wants to stretch the Italians. But they're not game for that. They'll just sit right up here in the neutral zone and hope they can absorb Canada's latest attack run. Maybe a little bit of crossing, circling around. Centering pass not on. And we'll wait. Is he going to take this shot now? He's going to put a little pressure on. Does the deke. Takes his time. No stress. Doesn't put any power on the shot. Maybe tries to swing it through the keeper's legs there. Looking for a cheeky bounce off the pads. Hopefully we can get a big wave and a big scream from all the students at the Hillcrest Middle School in Coquitlam. Rob Kramer wants to say hi to them all. Don't spill your lunch, kids. When Team Canada's playing, it's all right to take an afternoon off. And you pick the right afternoon to do it. 13 times. Canada's made it worth your while. So I'm sure all those kids are really proud to Sherry, Matthew, Nate. Happy birthday, Matthew. What a birthday present. There's also a big shout out going to Bella, Nico, and Danica. Dad's all doing their jobs out here and doing it very, very well. And I've had the pleasure of meeting them as well, too, in the hotel. They're not just top-class players, they're top-class blokes. And very glad to see them out here, wearing the maple leaf on their tops. Taking it easy in the Italian sunshine in the mountains, here in the Dolomites. Doing a professional job. Playing the puck around, tape to tape. Nice little masterclass in skill. Asking all the questions of the Italian B team. We've got the heart to make the runs when they get the chance. So can they do it? Cross ice, not deciding to take the pass to center. Now the Italians in a little bit of control. Long shot, just taken by the Canadian defender on the shoulder. Number 9 turning around. Trying to unwind the cork as the Italian team goes for some fresh legs. Italian team not willing to commit forward. At this stage, could it hurt? Maybe the Italians now time to start picking up stones from the floor and chucking them. Throw the fruit from the basket. Reach into your pockets. Sand and fluff, anything you've got. Start chucking it at them. Don't worry about the score line and just try and sign the score sheet for yourself. Little bit of possession here from the Italian team. Maybe just a chance for them to get a little feel of the puck on their sticks. Centering pass, two of them there. And for only the second time in this match, really, Canadian keeper tested. They took their time, the Italians, to set that up. Got the puck on the stick. Accuracy was there. Just couldn't quite find the power. And the Canadian keeper, like Sleeping Beauty, awoken from his slumber and ready for action when needed. That puck is deadly, bouncing off of the backboards, comes popping straight out. Designed for ice hockey pucks, not these light little plastic composites, and so they're pretty zippy when they come off those backboards. Good pressure. Holding onto that puck, centering pass. Tried to pop that up on the glove side where they know it's been successful before, but no dice this time. Italian keeper of having had a break for a little while now. Still holding at 13 with 7:06 to play. 77 pressing, just got caught with his skate there a little bit. Couldn't get rid of it. The Italians have got the possession. The centering pass wasn't quite on the tape. Just made number 28 stretch a little bit too far. And away the Canadians go. Not in any hurry. Just going to wait for the right opportunity. Takes the deke around. Goes around the back of the net. Waits for the outlet. Looks for someone in. Uses his power. He's not going to get taken off the puck easily. Little fluffer. Oh, tried to tip it cute in between his legs, number 77. It didn't quite come off. Canadians just in total control here. They can sort of decide when they want to score. Maybe taking their eye off the ball now. Maybe not quite on point anymore. Not too stressed. 13 goals. Just need that one more to equal the Slovaks. Does it matter? Let's find out. 6 minutes to play. Plenty of time. Fresh legs come out. Woo! Could take a little bit of luck there. Long stretching pass. Keeper's rolling around trying to keep it. Puck falls loose. Italians still got possession. Pops out to the corner. Right behind the net again. Italians could take this chance. Scoops it through. Cross ice. Centering pass doesn't come off. It goes behind the point player. Canadians gather. Take a little breath. Wipe the first drops of sweat from their brow. And then reset. Number 16, slap shot, wide. Bad angle from that, really. Russell wasn't quite on. Now he's going to get a chance, though. Redeem himself, takes his time. Wait till the keeper makes his move, but waits too long. Stretched it out. He's chewing on his mouth guard there. Probably a little bit disappointed with himself. Maybe could have done better. Canadians still waiting for this 14th goal to equal the Slovaks. Canadian number 22, Brian, giving the rest of his teammates a little nod, saying it's time to step up now. Here comes the goal right down Main Street. Takes the deke. Tries to go over the top again on the glove side, but went a little too high. Maybe just forgot that these first goals are a little low, bouncing off the keeper's stick there. Canadians still keep possession in the Italian zone. Ooh, just lost a balance there. Maybe trying to find that pass. But the Italians can go. 3-on-2. Slap shot from out. Well wide. And the Canadians have got man over. Crossing pass. Quick snapshot. And that's found the hole. And there he goes. Number 22 doing all the work. Patient. Underneath the stick. And number 19. Darren. Slotting it in. No trouble. Probably figured out where he's going to shoot it before the pass was made. If only the keeper had as well. And there's the 14. And now to do one better. Straight in, really good pace. Centering pass. Italians not really pushing the Canadians out of that slot. They're making it their own. It's as comfy as Sheldon's seat on the sofa. He's worn in a little patch there in front. Canadians very comfortable there. Italia have got to push them out. Now what have Italia B got in the locker? Can they push everything forward? Slap shot from downtown. Covered up by the keeper. Showing no signs of physical fatigue, but mentally might be really feeling it now. The Italians still got a grin on their face. Just a little offside behind the referee. Wants to go, go, go. Anticipated the Canadians winning the slap shots. Chasing, putting a little bit of pressure on now. This is probably the Italians' best strategy at this point. Throw some bodies forward. See if you can pick something up out of the rubbish. Canadians, tape to tape passing. Keeping the pressure on. Maybe just rushing that one a little bit, uncharacteristically. I think the Canadians could score at a nod here. Italians have got to just let that go. Throw some bodies forward. Take a risk. Will the Italians pull their keeper to try and get one on the score sheet? Changes up the face-off. Sends the Italian away. Canadians win without too much trouble. Here they come again. Slap shot. Wide. Hits the stick. Pops loose. What can the Italians do? They don't take it on. Mopped up at the back, the Canadian forechecker. Centering pass. Slap shot. Potted right in. Waste no time. And now, leave no doubt. The Canadians, definitive favorites in this pool. And looking more and more and more dangerous to the top teams. The Czechs will be watching closely. The Czech team, four-time World Cup holders. Though admittedly, from a much smaller pool of teams. The French, twice raising the cup themselves, looking pretty outstanding in their matches. Oh, out of nowhere, Canadians just took their eye off the ball there. Maybe thought they had done enough. The Italians circling around. Possession didn't look anything like dangerous. Dropped a forechecker deep, then popped out from behind the goal. Loose puck. Keeper didn't see it. And the Italians managed to do just enough to get themselves on the scoreboard. Now, what are the Canadians going to do about that? 2 minutes, 19 to play. They won't have liked that. They'll hardly be disappointed because they've all done their jobs absolutely properly. But that was always the danger if they took their eye off the ball. Started to fall asleep on the sofa. Tipped up puck just hitting the net in the back. Just let the remote slip from their hands onto the floor. Now they're startled, back awake. Yeah. 1:51 to play. Canada 15. Italia 1. A little bit of an untidy pass there, hitting the skate, but mopped up by number 44. Centering pass hits the Italian skate, then bounces back in behind. 44 again mops up. Takes the stick handling. And that's number 4 sticking to it. Hopefully that made them feel a little bit better about taking their eye off the ball at the back. They won't be disappointed with that. 16-1. 15 to add to their goal difference. Just enough to make that difference. So that they can bragging rights in the hotel tonight at dinner with the Slovaks. We scored one more than you. Ooh, a little bit of a chop there, 44. Feeling the pressure there. Won't bother him one little bit, but maybe surprised that the referees aren't calling their normal gentle, breezy touches. Will he make them pay? Not panicking. Stick handling straight into the front room, the Italians. Just a little untidy and couldn't make it count. This time they will. Canada 3-on-1, almost slap shot, waiting, finding his moment, just caught a stick there. And then there's the Italians dropping that one man late. Can he find the cross pass? He does, goes to the tape. Oh, wasn't quite convinced. Then the Canadians drop their low man, 87, all the way around, stretching. Using his offhand. He's almost stepping over the keeper. Keeper's helmet pops off in his efforts to try and stop that. And the Canadians getting their skills toolkit out and displaying all their shiny new spanners. That's a wrench for all you kiddies back home in the big country. And that draws to a close. Canada's third effort in this second day of the World Cup. Masters in line, 2016. And they've set their stall out very, very well. Exactly as they intended. Slowed their game down, played professional, did their jobs exactly right, stuck to the game plan. And had the pick of the goals to score at will when they wanted, as they wanted. Probably forgiven for maybe just taking their eye off the ball just at the last. The Italian team, exactly as predicted, maybe throwing whatever was left in the bottom of their own basket up into the air to see what came out, emptying their pockets, and just caught a little lucky bobble and slotted in. Canadian keeper only really being tested about three times in the entire match. Number 44 just getting a little bit of an earful about how things went down on the pitch. But these old pros know exactly how these games pan out and why. And I think the Italians know that they've just witnessed a pretty spectacular display of professional, organized, structured, determined hockey. And nonetheless, fair, honorable. And the Canadians displaying their respect for the challenge that the Italians have taken on in coming out and meeting these Canadians. Just as promised by their captain, Mike, winding all the way through the gears. If this is third, I can't wait to see fourth. But they might just need it, because the French and the Czechs are another prospect still. And the Italian team, absolute stalwarts, great battlers, really pleased and proud to be able to come out and face these Canadians, known worldwide for their hockey pedigree. And I know, having spoken to some of them, how excited they were to come and share this pitch with them.